On June 16th, a joint convoy of the Turkish army and the Russian military police became a target of a new IED attack during the patrol along the M4 highway in southern Idlib. The explosion damaged a BTR-82A armored personnel carrier of the Russian military police but led to no casualties. The incident happened near the village of Alkiyasat, which was located on about half of the patrol route that covers the area between Tarnbar and Furayka. Idlib militants and their radical supporters regularly stage provocations in an attempt to sabotage the implementation of the Turkish-Russian de-escalation agreement on southern Idlib. These provocations, including IED attacks, already led to casualties among the Turkish military. Despite this, Ankara continues protecting Hayatullah al-Sham and other terrorist groups, claiming that they are a kind of moderate opposition. This behavior encourages militant groups for more aggressive action. However, as the practice demonstrates, if these attacks lead to real casualties or equipment losses, Russia, contrary to Turkey, will not tolerate this situation and will resume full-scale operations against these groups, even despite moderate opposition mantras from Ankara. Turkish-backed militant groups announced that they conducted an operation against cells of the Kurdish People's Protection Unit, YPG, involved in 11 bombing attacks in the Turkish-occupied Syrian region of Afrin. As of June 17th, at least 7 supposed YPG members were detained. Turkish-backed groups lay blame on any terrorist attacks or explosions that happened there on the YPG. On the other hand, the YPG and affiliated groups regularly announce attacks on Turkish proxies in the Afrin area, but they have never claimed responsibility for any bombing in civilian areas. In the evening of June 16th, Turkey launched an active phase of its Operation Claw Tiger in Iraq's Haftanin region. According to the Turkish military, the Turkish Armed Forces artillery hit at least 150 Kurdistan Workers' Party PKK targets, while commandos supported by attack helicopters conducted raids on the ground. The Operation Claw Tiger covers the Iraqi areas of Sinjar, Kandil, Karachak, Zap, Afasin Basyan, and Harkuk, and is aimed at neutralizing bases, weapon depots, and training camps of the PKK there. Turkish forces regularly conduct anti-PKK operations in northern Iraq, but they have still not been able to fully neutralize the armed group there. At the same time, pro-Turkish sources are speculating that Ankara will soon resume military actions against the YPG, which it considers a PKK affiliate in northeastern Syria. Right now, Turkish-backed forces are building up their presence near Ayn Issa. The formal pretext of this military effort will be the unwillingness of the Kurdish fighters to withdraw from the 30-kilometer deep border area, as it was agreed in the framework of the US-Russia-Turkey de-escalation agreement on the region.